Welcome back to the Nutramedical Report, and coming up tomorrow, we're going to have Dr. Robert Felix. Dr. Robert Felix on the program. Dr. Mayer, can you give us some more input as to what is happening with our current system and why the legal system is being taken apart and the public health officials, the state legislators, the attorneys, no one's actually taking action against this except for us citizens out here trying to file these injunctions. It's remarkable the level of silence in this extreme danger.
I think you're right. I think the irony is that the this is the government for the people, by the people, you know, I think the lawyers have gotten very comfortable in their concept of making a living by suing individual people, and as opposed to looking at the real problem, the really big problem, you know. And our public health officials, if you want to call them that, I really haven't acted in years as far as really looking at protecting the people.
No.
You know, we have to go back to the last commissioner from the Food and Drug Administration, who I thought was really exceptionally credible, and I'll remember his name in a minute. He was an MD and a JD, and he was a Bush appointment, Bush 1.
Right.
He went to medical school and law school at the same time, which is kind of a fascinating thing. He walked into a Jewel food store here in Chicago, and he brought an axe with him, and he went into the where it said fresh orange juice, and he smashed it up, and he said, "If something is frozen, by definition, it's not fresh." And then someone questioned him, and he said, "Well, how do you know that? Maybe it is fresh." And his answer was something that all of us should remember. Your grandmother and my grandmother knows when something is frozen, it's not fresh. End of story. You know?
Right.
And I think that's the same thing with the vaccines. You know, it's our so-called, quote, experts have gotten infatuated with this. They're even afraid. I mean, do you think the president has any clue to what's going on? You know, and the funniest thing is, in times past, a president wouldn't have given dangerous things to his own children. I am thoroughly convinced that when the swine flu comes, Obama's children will be the first ones to line up because he's so rapidly ready to do this. That's how sad it is, in a sense.
He is a narcissistic, what I call a megalomaniac, and he is a prancing prince of darkness, a false prophet of peace and security and an economic demolition, a transfer of wealth to the global corporate elite, and he doesn't care, as long as they worship him and think he's wonderful.
Yeah, that's exactly it. He doesn't care, and that's very frightening, you know. I'm very excited, Bill, because, you know, I've got a very good outlook right now. I didn't for a long time. My feeling is, Dr. Mendelsohn, my mentor, used to say that the worse things get, the better it is for us, because all of a sudden there'll be a wake-up, but it won't be in the government, you know. I didn't think I would see a time where millions of people are refusing vaccines.
Yeah, including doctors, by the way.
But this,
More doctors, by the way. This is something I hear because I hear it after the show. I get calls from doctors. Oh, that was quite a show with Mayer. I'm sure I'll get calls today from MDs, DOs, dentists, naturopaths, massage therapists, etc. And they'll be saying, wow, all of our colleagues aren't taking all these shots they recommend for adults now. All of us don't give all our kids all these shots, even though in our offices we give them to the children. How unethical is that? The doctors still prescribe the shots when they themselves don't take them or even give them to their own families.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, but I think it's just a matter of time before they realize, hopefully, we don't run out of time, and that's what you've been saying.
Well, I'm worried about a false flag because, you see, when our numbers look like we're about to win, they're about to pull at the stops. And I think that we're very likely that we're going to have an economic false flag. We're going to have a biological false flag. We're going to have a war false flag with them pushing the state of Israel toward a state of war. I think that things are going to come undone here shortly by design because they're afraid we're winning, and we are.
I think so. I really do believe you're right, you know, I don't know. I mean, you know, I told you this earlier. I've never been afraid to be in this country. I've listened to you and Alex Jones and all the people I love because I've always felt the truth. But I didn't think, as we said earlier, it was so close upon us. That's what's so scary.
Yeah, but they shouldn't feel secure if they're in Ecuador or Guatemala or Switzerland. There's no safe place if you don't fight for the truth, because this plague of forced vaccinations is just not a U.S. issue. It's not just a Canadian issue. It's a Ugandan issue. It's an Indian issue. It's a Chinese issue. This is going to spread worldwide.
I think you're 100% right, you know, and I just pray it's not too late, because, you know, I don't think it's a matter of convincing anyone anymore, because I think that's happening by itself. But this is the plague, not the disease that they worry about, but this is the plague. And unfortunately, if too many people get infected, I mean, we are really finished. I mean, it's really just frightening. I mean, I never thought that vaccines would bring the world down. It sounds like
if you talk to Dr. Carley, she might.
Armaments, and you know, and all of a sudden, it's something that we have within our midst that we willingly did. Very frightening.
I want people to, as I say, just like the movie Network, I don't want them to throw their TV out of the window. I want them to get out of their chair, and I want them to put their ear to the floor and hear the hoofbeats of the riders of the apocalypse. I want them to understand that this is not a theory. We're not conspiracy theorists. We are conspiracy realists. We are agenda analysts. We're telling them, scientifically, technically, and otherwise, that this is about to happen. They're now saying that they'll have vaccine from China in as little as August, which is like 6 weeks away, 8 weeks away. They're talking about the idea of enforcing vaccines. I've got the bills here from Massachusetts, the federal declarations by Obama that he's going to give us three shots. And they're telling us that we are a public health danger if we don't get a shot to everyone else. This is very dangerous policy to take away our personal autonomy. If you don't have control of yourself, and you have hate speech, so denying vaccines as safe, denying carbon credits, denying these other things, what do you have? You have nothing. You have no private property. You have nothing.
Dr. Bill, that it may be redeeming is something very sad. There are over 2 million children that now have been damaged by vaccines. And there's a point where people get so fed up with this, you know. You can only push so and so long, including a doctor in Florida who I met a few months ago, has two vaccine-damaged children. They're severely damaged. He's a multi-millionaire, separate from medicine. He told me a few weeks ago he is ready to spend every penny of his wealth, because he said, I have no wealth. He said, my children are damaged. That's my wealth. It's gone.
Right.
You know, every penny. He spends every waking moment to talk to legislators. He's very good friends with the present governor of Florida.
What's his name?
He told the governor, he said, you better start passing bills to stop vaccines. You know, so it's kind of interesting.
What's his name? I'd like to know it.
Pardon?
What's his name?
I'll tell you, it's Dr. Gary. That's his first name. He goes by Dr. Gary. You know, uh-huh. He's got billboards all over Florida because he runs an incredible clinic. You know, he made a lot of money, you know, with car insurance, and doing a nice job. You know, he really, and he's someone you want on your show also, because
he's so angry.
He has his own private plane. And he wanted to fly me down to Florida, which I said, no, I'll take a commercial plane. You don't have to fly to Chicago to pick me up, just to testify in front of the Florida Senate, the Florida State House. Imagine how stupid this is. You have to spend time, energy, to pass a bill to get a toxin, mercury, out of vaccines. That was, they passed it in the first rounds, and of course, then it got defeated. But I said, no, Dr. Gary, you made the impact. You know, there are now 10 times as many people who are not going to vaccinate because of what you did. What they do in the Florida legislature doesn't make any difference, you know. What makes a difference is we got people who are defying. You know, this reminds me of Spartacus.
Remember, yeah, exactly.
Spartacus? You know, when they damage your children, they've taken everything away
from
you. And they don't have to take your money. Your money, what do you do with your money? You know?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. We are now at the point where we know what's on the table. It's us. It's our children. It's our lives. So we're going to have, Dr.